Hey, it's Kurt at the Top Corner Hockey Studios. Top Corner Hockey on Facebook, Top Corner Kurt on Instagram. Thanks for watching. I think it's fair to say that anyone who plays hockey loves to score goals. I think even if you're a goalie or a defensive-minded player, you love to score goals. I know when I played, I loved to score goals. Now, I love watching players score goals, and I think the prettier the goal, the more I enjoy watching them. NHL players are no different, I think. I think they love to score goals. Sometimes it's really clear. You can tell that when they score goals, they love to do it. Sometimes when they score outrageously creative goals, you can tell by the smile on their face that they've just pulled off something really fun and really incredible, and that it's still a fun game for them to play. Sometimes players come up with some really creative and inventive ways to score goals. I think you have to, with goaltending and defense being as strong as they are today. Sometimes the only way to score a goal is to get really creative. Let's take a look at my top 10 creative goals. The only rule is that I think the players in these goals must be trying to do what they're trying to do. Now, there is going to be some luck involved, but I think as long as the effort is there and the outcome was there, I think it counts in this list. Let's take a look. All right, this first one is not an official part of the list because he didn't score, but I wanted to show you Pittsburgh's Phil Bourque flip his blade on a breakaway against Detroit's Tim Cheveldae. The game must have been out of hand, or perhaps Bourque was just really having fun at the moment. Imagine if he would have scored. All right, number 10, Marek Milik, between his legs, shootout goal. Back when the NHL started using the shootout to break ties, it was new and it was pretty cool. I was a fan of the shootout back then. Not anymore, I wish it would go away. But back in 2005, the Capitals and the Rangers went through a really fun 15-round shootout. The length of it meant some less offensive-minded guys got a shot. New York defenseman Marek Milik wasn't expecting to do much against Olaf Kolzig, but the big man surprised everyone by putting a stick between his legs and firing the puck top corner to win the game. And his celebration is so cool, it's like he's done it a million times before. Since Milik has done this, a couple of guys, like Thomas Hertl, have tried it and done it during a game. Number 9, Bobby Ryan using another player's stick and wrong hand with it too. The 2010-2011 season was a career year for Bobby Ryan. The third-year Duck posted 71 points that season, including 34 goals. None of them, however, matched this one against Minnesota. Up 4-2, Ryan has his stick stolen by Mikko Koivu. Ryan briefly complains to the ref, but understands he's on offense and doesn't want to waste the opportunity. So he decides to pick up Koivu's stick, even though it's the wrong hand. And just a moment later, he's left wide open at the side of the Minnesota net and pots one. Immediately, Ryan shows off the stick to Koivu to say thanks. What a gentleman. Number 8, Sidney Crosby batting it out of the air twice against Dallas. Sidney Crosby has been the best player in the NHL for most of the last 12 years. He's made some magical plays and scored a ton of beautiful goals. This one against Philadelphia is one of my favorites. Tipping the puck in behind him and between his legs is off the charts for creativity. But I'm going to go with this one against Dallas from earlier in the 2016-17 season. A lot of players have banked the puck in off players and goalies in the past, and that's what Sid is trying to do here. But when his first attempt doesn't work, Sid gives it another go and whacks his own rebound out of the air, behind the net, and in. That is awesome. Number 7, Dale Hawerchuk, up and over the net. If not for Wayne Gretzky, Dale Hawerchuk would certainly have a few Hart trophies to his name. The first overall pick in 1981 had a great career in Winnipeg, and it continued in Buffalo after he was traded to the Sabres in 1990. Playing at the Old Joe in Detroit one night, Hawerchuk was behind the wing's net when the puck bounced up and over the goal. Ducky alertly sped to the front of the net where he whacked a backhander past a surprise. Although Hawerchuk didn't mean to flick the puck over the net, he certainly knew he could get to the loose puck and score. A few years later, Pavel Bure tried to do this himself against Toronto as he flipped the puck over, but he fanned on his attempt. Still, a lot of creativity to make the goalie lose sight of the puck and take advantage of that. Number 6, Stevie Y flips it into the empty net. Usually, empty net goals are nothing special. Often when they're scored, people start leaving the building. Most of the time, an empty netter is either a long bomb or close enough to just tap it in. Man, I love that movie. But when you've got a player as talented as Steve Yzerman, the conventional way doesn't always mean it's the right move. In this example, Stevie Y has an Oiler defender between him and the yawning cage. Rather than trying to go around the D-man, Yzerman calmly flips the puck over the head of the Oiler and easily deposits the puck into the net. The smile on Yzerman's face after tells me he's been waiting for an opportunity to use this move. His coach Jacques Demers is blown away by this, and so am I. Number 5, Mike Ribeiro's stick-behind-the-back OT goal. The Dallas Stars may have missed the playoffs in 2011-12, but nobody missed this slick play by Mike Ribeiro. Trying to end a 3-game losing streak, the Stars hosted the Calgary Flames. Tied at 2 in overtime, the puck comes to Ribeiro, who twirls his stick around his body to shake off Scott Hannon. The unusual move works as it gives Ribeiro time and space to load up and fire a rocket past Mika Kiprusoff, giving the Stars the overtime win. Always a bit of a showboat in his career, Ribeiro sometimes got criticized for his shake and bake, but not this one. Number 4, Mario into Bork skates. Although Mario only played 64 games in 1991-92, he still won the scoring title with 131 points. In the playoffs, though, Lemieux took it up a notch and scored 16 goals and 34 points in only 15 games. During the Whales final against Boston, Mario Lemieux scored perhaps his most famous goal of his career. While killing a penalty, Mario stole the puck and raced the other way. But with Bruins defenseman Ray Bourque still in his way, Mario decided to attack him rather than go around him. Mario was able to catch Bourque in between turning and going back by putting the puck in Bourque's skates. With no way to defend it, Bourque was confused and helpless. Mario got past Bourque and naturally went top corner on Andy Moog for one of the most creative goals anyone has ever seen. Number 3, Ron Francis bats the puck out of the air in between his legs. This one is a little similar to Dale Hawerchuk's goal from earlier, but I think it's a lot better. Although the 96-97 Pittsburgh Penguins were not the juggernaut they were in the early 90s, 33-year-old Ron Francis demonstrated on this crazy goal he still had soft hands. I remember watching this game too. The Leafs were hosting the Penguins. Pittsburgh was on a power play with Mario, Jagr, and Francis out there. Jagr's shot is stopped by Felix Potvin, but the puck goes straight up in the air. Francis does the unimaginable and bats the puck out of the air between his legs with his back to the net. How in the world he did this is really unbelievable. I couldn't believe he scored on that play when I watched it, and I still can't believe it now. Number 2, Gretzky batting it in against Vancouver. What would be a list of great goals without one from the great one? Although Wayne didn't spin magic like Mario and Bure did in the 90s, Gretzky could still score. This is probably my favorite Wayne Gretzky goal, in fact. The Kings are home to Vancouver and 99 wires a shot towards Kirk McLean. The puck goes off a stick and hits Luke Robitaille in the back, forcing the puck way up in the air. Gretzky catches everyone off guard by hammering this puck past McLean with a frozen rope, batting the puck out of the air with a baseball swing. Now, batting the puck in is nothing new, but 99 takes a real solid baseball approach to this one. And short of a leg kick, it's a perfect home run swing. You can tell he's pretty happy with his idea. Number 1, Brett Hull's bet bank shot. This one may not be the most creative goal, but I really love it, so I'm going to make it my number 1. From the start of the 1989-90 season to the end of the 93-94 season, Brett Hull scored 339 goals in just 392 games. Wow, he was unstoppable. Following three straight 70-plus goal seasons, Hull must have felt like he could do anything. So in a game against the New York Islanders, it looks like Hull deliberately rips this shot high off the glass, off Ron Hextall's back and in the net. Look at the reaction of Hull and his line mates giving teammate Rick Zombo. It's like Hull bet Zombo that he could do this exact play. I think Hull did it on purpose because there's no way a goal scorer like Hull would miss the net by this much. You don't score 700 career goals with bad accuracy. I think Hull absolutely meant to do this, and it leaves both Hextall and Zombo in disbelief. I think my favorite part of watching those crazy creative goals is watching the players' reaction. You can see by the big smiles on their face, they're pretty happy with what they've been able to accomplish. In some cases, I think that they've been trying those moves and that it actually worked. It was a lot of fun to watch. In some of those examples, that's the only case I've ever seen something like that. Like Yzerman's empty net flip and Lemieux putting it in Bork's skates to fool him. Never seen anything like that before, since then or ever. What's your favorite crazy creative goal? Was there a goal on here you think that I missed and would like to see added? Let me know in the comments below. Please continue to like and subscribe. I'm Kurt. This is Top Corner Hockey. Thanks for watching. See you next time.